Let's move on to the beams above the columns and use them to learn about further methods of reinforcement input. We switch to sheet RC03 into section 3. Here we select the left beam, next our rebar tool, the closed stirrup bending shape, layout rule, maximum spacing of 150 mm, and a bar diameter of 10 mm. So far, everything is as usual, but now we want to directly specify the desired dimensions of the stirrup during input. For this, we use a new placement method here, by 2 points, and enter our stirrup using a rectangle. By using the tab key, we can precisely control the height of the stirrup and avoid uneven segment lengths. We can also now see the rebars in half tone of the column. I recommend occasionally checking the 3D view to detect potential collisions early on. In this case, there is no problem as our stirrup placement ends at the edge of the column. We will model the connecting rebars between the column and the beams in a later video. Now let's move on to the longitudinal bars of our beam. Here we select the straight bar, and for this shape, we have another placement orientation available, the perpendicular segment. We set the number of bars to 2, the bar diameter to 16, and click once in our beam for the first rebar of the set and once for the last one. Now we mirror this rebar set upwards and set the diameter to 12 millimeters. And we're done. For the lateral longitudinal bars, we also need the straight bar. I set the number to 5, the diameter to 10 millimeters, and place them the same way as before. It's nice to see how the rebars distribute evenly over the desired length. Moving on, the endpoint of the rebar set should be up here. Then we press escape. We select the rebar set, and to avoid having duplicate bars in the corners, we deactivate the first and last rebar of the rebar set using the small checkboxes. Now let's move on to another particularly important tool, the Edit Constraints tool. Each circle represents a constraint of our vertical rebar set. Here we have the beginning of the rebar set, the position of the bars, and the end of the set. To change a constraint, we select it and then select a constraint target. Currently, it is the component edge, as we can clearly see in orange. You can select a concrete cover or any other rebar. I now select the stirrup, and we see how the rebar set aligns with the stirrup. With this offset dimension, we can now control the exact position. Here, by using the upper symbol, we decide whether the offset should be clear spacing or the bar axis. We can see how the dimension adjusts instantly when we toggle between the options. The lower icon allows us to define whether the constraint should be uni or bidirectionally. Let's leave it as it is and finish editing the constraints. You can find a detailed explanation of different symbols in the Revit help by clicking F1. All right, back to Revit. The constraints are saved and will also affect future changes. Let's move the stirrup here, and we can see how our longitudinal bars follow the geometry of the stirrup. We quickly create a copy of our sidebars, use the constraints to attach them to the right segment of our rebar, and click OK. Now, I encourage you to independently reinforce the second smaller beam to the right. Feel free to play around with the tools you have learned so far, and I recommend trying out different input methods to deepen your understanding of the advantages and disadvantages depending on the situation.